Let us answer the very first question. Choose a figure which would most closely resemble the unfolded form of the figure Z. Okay, if you observe, the figure Z is over here. But before that, we have two, X and Y, where from X is the initial point, if I'm not wrong. So X to Z, one fold, and Y to Z, one more fold happened. Now, let me just take you through a concept, okay, a small concept. Let me take a square paper where I have made a fold over here. Now, what exactly is the figure you are going to get? Guess. Some of your guesses are correct. It's a right angle triangle. Let me assume that I'm making a hole over here. Now, I ask you to unfold the paper and tell me where exactly this punch is all over the paper. Now, when you just unfold it to the top, right, you're going to get back to a paper, a square paper, exactly what you have taken. And you're going to get the impression, the other impression over the which side, exactly on top of it. Why? Because the top hole must be symmetric, as well as that hole must be on top of this hole when folded or unfolded. Yes or no, yes? That is one point you should remember. So for one fold, how many impressions you got? Exactly, you got two impressions and made a hole, okay? And made a hole or whatever the impression is. So you'll get two impressions per shot. Now, let me take one more example. Let me take again a piece of paper. Now you are folding in this way, right? So you're going to get a rectangle shaped box. Now you are making one more fold over here. So tell me which shape you'll be having a piece of paper. It'll be a quarter of the paper. If I make an impression over here or a hole over here. Now, if I am asking you back to unfold it and tell me where exactly the holes will be there on the piece of paper. You tell me, just give a guess. So first of all, we have to unfold it in the first part. That is this part, back to this, right? Now, when you unfold, you'll get in this way, correct? Now, I told you just now, the other hole, when folded or unfolded, it should be on top of this. That means it should be over here, right? And they are symmetrical to each other, correct? Now, again, one more fold is there where we have to unfold it. So it should be unfolded to the top now. When unfolded to the top, the two holes are over here already. When unfolded to the top, again, there's two holes on top, which should be symmetric, as well as when folded or unfolded, they should be on top of the previous holes, correct? So they would be over here. Yes or no, yes? I hope you understood this concept, yes. Look, why I told you this concept? Because it helps you a lot now, right? Let me check. Look, I can conclude one thing. One fold and made a hole, you'll get two impressions. Two folds, and when made an impression, when made a hole, you'll get how many impressions here? Exactly, you'll get four impressions. Now, from the same data, you tell me which option can be eliminated for sure. Yeah. Now, if you observe, first fold is over here, second fold is over here, and they have made an impression over here in this way, right? This together is an impression. Let us say this together is an impression. Now, so tell me how many impressions we should get? Exactly four impressions of such. But in the option one, there are only two impressions, which is definitely a wrong answer. I need to get four minimum, right? Now, if you observe, which option can be eliminated among 2, 3, 4? Just guess. Pause the video and try to answer. I hope you guessed. Now, I can eliminate one more option for sure. Why? Look, if you observe over here, let me erase the part over here so that gives you a clear picture. Now, this part over here, when unfolded, I'll get definitely over here, correct? Now, so 2, 3, 4 agrees with the down part. With the down part, degrees. But when unfolded it to the other half, that is this way, when unfolded to the other half, now where should I get the impressions? The impressions must be symmetric to this, as well as when folded or unfolded, they should be on top of this, as in they should match to each other. Now tell me, is option two is matching that? No, this is actually just one fold, if I'm not wrong, either fold or unfold. So it's actually only one fold and cut, one fold and cut. And four impressions, as in 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this option can be eliminated again. But if you observe 3 and 4, tell me which is the right one in between these two. Definitely down part is correct. But if you observe, when you unfold it, I told you, these four must be aligned or on top of each other, right? So these are the exact four things which will be aligned on top of each other when folded. But this one, are they going to align? No. So option four is eliminated. The only option that fits exactly here is option three. I hope everybody understood this explanation, BS. So using this fold and impressions part, you can eliminate some options, and also using the symmetry and on top of the other hole, you can eliminate some other options. But now, let me show you a better method and much simpler method, which makes you to understand this question in a very easy manner. But then using this approach might be considered as a malpractice in the examination. Let me actually show you the approach now. So what I have done, you are able to see. I have just taken a piece of paper and I have exactly folded in the same way. First fold and then the second fold, right? You're able to see over here. Right, everybody? Just observe what I have done. Okay, this is the exact figure I have taken, Z figure. And when unfolded the first part, I have two figures, whereas first and the second. And second fold, if you observe, four parts I have. First, second, third is over here, and then fourth impression is over here. Right? So this would be very, very easy. This takes hardly 10 to 15 seconds to give impressions, right? Right? So these impressions are like folds. So when you unfold, you'll get exactly the shaded parts or the impressions over there, which will give you a very easy answer called option 3 without much efforts. I hope you like this trick a lot, right? But I hope you understood both the methods. Now let us move on to the next question. Acid. These were the actual questions that were taken from the previous year asked questions. So the pictures might be blur, everybody. Okay, just keep a note on that. But for your information, I just give you the exact picture of this. Okay, now what you have to do, just listen. Which is the exact water image of the following? Now, what is a water image? For example, let us say this is the water we have. Okay, this is the water we have. Now, let me take a figure called 7. Now, tell me how does it look like? It should be a water image, no? So it should be exactly like a reversal, if I'm not wrong, right? So when again folded or unfolded, the edges should be on top of each other and they should align on with each other, correct? So the 3 points over here must be aligned to the 3 points over down. So that is nothing but the remaining image, right? Now you tell me what is the first option that can be eliminated actually. Now again, just represent a water image over here. So first of all, the figures should be respective to each other, but what is non-respective one? Option A is a irrespective one. Why? Because L should be over here and 5 should be over here, but these are interchanged. That means option A is eliminated, right? Now, considering option B, C, D, tell me which options can be eliminated again. Now, AB is on the top right corner, right? Now, when the water image, where it should be on the bottom right corner, correct? But if you observe, option D has in the left bottom corner, which is again eliminated, right? It should be over here if I'm not wrong, right? AB should be over here. So again, option D is gone. Now in between B and C, you tell me what is the correct option. Look, if you observe the L and the 5, they are correct. Why? Because L would be over here. The 3 points would be aligned to each other. Similarly, when 5, the 3 points or any points, they'll be aligned to each other, right? Exactly. So these are aligned. L and 5 are aligned. But if you observe A and B, right? Now let me take A over here and then B over here. Now when you do water image, B should be look like what? It should look like a P, right? It should look like a P. But if you observe option C, we have a 9 figure, but instead of P figure, right? Which easily can be eliminated. So the only option that is exactly the water image is option B, right? I hope everybody understood how to solve the water images. Just focus on the figure and just check with the alignments, everybody. Alignments are very, very important, okay? Right? The alignment of the points are very important. So based on that, we can easily eliminate the options, right? And also the sides, which side are what? And when water image, which side they'll be? Let us go for the next question. Okay, again, a paper fold and cuts or impressions. Now, you know, the very first method, a general method, or the paper method, right? I hope you like the paper method a lot. And you just try once by pausing the video. And once you are done, you can just watch the video and confirm your answer. Okay. So just pause it and do it. I hope you did. Now, let me continue. Now, if you observe, the first fold is happened over here and the second fold is happened over here. Now, actually, if you observe here, after the second fold, the paper should look like this. But if given, the figure is like a triangle. How is it possible? Nothing much. They have just rotated this base, or they have just made this base to get the on top of the ground. Okay, so that will be a triangle. Now let us see what we should do. Choose a figure which would most closely resemble the unfolded form of the figure. So these are folded form of the figure and ABCD are the unfolded forms, right? I hope you did in both the general method and also the the paper method. Let's answer the question now. There is a small impression over here, right? Let us say there is an impression or a cut, let it be anything, right? Now, if you observe over here, we should unfold it basically. When you unfold it, right? If you unfold it, you'll get a triangle, right? You'll get a triangle in this way. Right, everybody? And as you have unfolded, this would be projected over here. Correct, everybody? So this will be like a dot, a semi dot, or a semicircle, correct? Now, again, one more unfold. These are first unfold and second unfold should be over here to get a paper. Correct, everybody? Now, when you unfold it to the top, again, it should be having a other shaded part over here or the other impression over here. Now, tell me which of the options I can eliminate easily. Option D, why? Because definitely there should be a shaded part or an impression over here. Correct? Now, let us check the other things. Now, we have two dots under the shaded part that is over here. Now, first is over here actually. When you unfold it, you should get the exactly the same two impressions over here, right? That are to be over here. Right, everybody? Now, again, you should do one more unfold, which is over here. So, when you do one more unfold, where exactly you should get? The impressions must match these two. So, over here and over here. Okay, so that they'll be matched to each other. These two and these two. These two and then these two. Right, everybody? These will be matched. So, tell me which of the figure you can eliminate again. You should get all around 8 dots. Right? But you have, in the option C, you have only 4 which are gone. Now, you tell me what should be the next one. Again, you have a square-shaped impression over here. So, that square shape will be actually over here. And when you unfold it, it will be over here. Now, when you again unfold to the other side, it will be over here and then over here. Right? So, 4 dots I should get. So, easily I can eliminate option B also by because I have only 2 dots over there. So, right? So, the only option that is possible is option A. Right? I hope you like this trick a lot and you are enjoying it. So, this is the very general method that is assumption or by imaginative. Right? Now, let me take you to the paper cut. Let us take a paper and then do it, which is a very basic thing. So, here we have exactly the same resemblance over here and over here. Right? Now, let's see what happens when I unfold it actually and then let me do it. Okay? And this is just for better understanding. Okay? So, let's see what happens when I unfold the paper. If you just unfold the paper onto the right, you'll have exactly over this. Right, the impressions you are able to see very clearly. And then one more unfold will give you the exact figure of the same, right, that we have in option A. Right, everybody? So that's very simple and that's very easy. Right, I hope you love the trick a lot. So that says option A will definitely be the answer. Let us go for one more question. Direction. In the following question, one of the figures is different from the list. Spot the figure. Fine, you have A, B, C, D and one of the figures is definitely different from the other three. So, which one is that? Right, we have 2 points that we can point out. What are they? One is arrow and the other is a shaded part. Right, so guess what is the wrong one? Or just try to answer. Just pause the video and do that. I hope you did. Now, let me try to answer the question. If you observe to the arrow mark and to the shaded part, if you observe in between, there are 2 spaces. Similarly, over here, 2 spaces. Similarly over here, 2 spaces. But if you observe over here, there are 3 spaces, which is completely a wrong one. Now you can ask me, sir, what about the other part? Now let me go for it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these 3 are same to each other. As in, they have the same characteristics, right? When it comes to the arrow and the shaded part, they have 2 spaces in between and 5 spaces in between the other side. Correct? Now, if you observe option D, 1, 2, 3, and only 4 we have in between. So, if you observe here, so in between the arrow and the shaded part, there are 3 on the one side and 4 on the other side. Right, everybody? But it should be 2 and 5. So, odd man out is option D. I hope you understood the question and also you answered the question. Let us answer this question. Direction. A set of problem figures and answer figures are given below. In problem figures, the images are related in some way. So, choose the correct figure from the answer figure to complete the series. Fine. So we have to complete actually the given series over here. Okay. And we have to choose one option out of all these four. So let us observe the series that is happening over here and try to fill this blank out of the options. If you observe the very first figure, an acid, these were actual questions, so it might not be clear. Okay. So if you observe very clearly, these were the lines that were given over here. Right. This is the first figure we have. Right. And then suddenly, how many branches got increased? Let us say this is a branch. Right. And say this is one more branch. So for in the first figure, we have two branches. Now in the third figure, how many branches we have? Exactly. We have two more branches that got increased. Right. Where are they? Like this is getting one more pair. And on to the down part, we have one more branch over that is formed. Right. Now, so that is the second one. Now, third one, again, how many branches got increased? Now, again, a pair for this and then one more branch. So if you observe, there are two branches that were increased every time, right? So from the first figure, two branches. From the second to third figure, two branches. Similarly, from the third to fourth figure also, two more branches that should be increased. Now, let us first represent the third figure, okay? So that we can go accordingly. Now, this is the figure given, right? Now, so tell me how many branches should get increased from the third to fourth? Again, two more branches, right? So the first branch, that should be a pair for this, right? And then the next branch should be a pair for this, right? So tell me which option has the exact figure as a fourth one, right? Exactly. That is nothing but option C as my answer. I hope everybody understood the question. If not, just watch the part again. You'll get it. Let us answer the very last question of the video. Which figure is the odd one out? Now, if you observe, there are four options. One of these must be odd one, right? Odd one as in three of them will have similar characteristics, right? Similar to each other. But whereas the other one would be different. That is why it is called as odd one out. Now, so you tell me, what are your observations? Just pause the video and try to answer on your own. I hope you did. Now, let me explain the point. So if you observe, there are two things over here. One is shaded and the other are not shaded part or unshaded parts. Unshaded parts. Okay. Now, shaded parts, if you observe, these are in the same sector, if I'm not wrong. Everywhere, they belong to the same sector. Right? So the shaded parts over in the same sector. Those were that is the similarity that I can observe for the shaded parts. Now, unshaded parts, if you observe, right, I'll tell you what is the wrong answer first. The wrong answer is A. I'll tell you why here. If you observe the other options, B, C, D, every unshaded part is like the same shape. If you observe this shape like a B, okay, let me just represent with a different color. This is like a B and it's just rotated to the other side. Okay, just rotated, right, towards 90 degree, I can say. Now, if you observe here also the same. In C, here we have, and in C, it is just rotated 90 degrees and it's like a this shape, right? Now in D also the same. Initially, let us say this is this shape and then it just rotated to 90 degrees and then it became this shape, right? So these are the same characteristics of B, C and D. But if you observe option A, it is over here. Let us imagine the starting part is over here, but when it rotates to anti-clockwise direction, it should be the unshaded part should be facing this direction, right, everybody? But it is facing the opposite direction, which means definitely this is my odd one out. And that's option A is not, right, everybody? So that's all for the video, everybody. I hope you like the video a lot. Thank you for watching the video till the end. If you like the video, do not forget to press the like button. Also join our social media handles like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. As mentioned, links to all these handles are given in the description below. Thank you all.